Hello dear students, I hope all of you are fine. In our previous lecture, we studied Nelson Mandela Long Walk to Freedom. We have discussed the lesson and we have also done the textual questions. Now it's time for working with language. Question number 2. Read the paragraph below. Fill in the blanks with the noun forms of the verbs in brackets. In the bracket, verbs are given and we will fill in the blanks with their noun form. Let's read the given paragraph and try to fill in the blanks. Martin Luther King's dash to our history as an outstanding leader began when he came to the dash of Rosa Parks, a seamstress who refused to give up her seat on a bus to a white passenger. In those days, American blacks were confined to positions of second-class citizenship by restrictive laws and customs. To break these laws would mean dash and dash by the police and the legal system, beatings, dash, and sometimes death awaited those who defied the system. Martin Luther King's tactics of protest involved non-violent dash to racial injustice. Dear students, the verbs given are contribute, assist, subjugate, humiliate, imprison, and resist. Now we will use the noun form of these given verbs. Let's try. Martin Luther King's dash. Verb given is contribute. The noun form of this verb is contribution. Martin Luther King's contribution to our history as an outstanding leader began when he came to the given verb is assist. Noun form is assistance of Rosa Parks, a seamstress who refused to give up her seat on a bus to a white passenger. In those days, American blacks were confined to position of second-class citizenship by restrictive laws and customs. To break these laws would mean, given verb is subjugate, and noun form will be subjugation, and given verb is humiliate. The noun form will be humiliation by the police and the legal system. Beatings dash, verb form given is imprison. Noun will be imprisonment, and sometimes death awaited those who defied the system. Martin Luther King's tactics of protest involved non-violent. Verb given is resist, and we will make the noun resistance to racial injustice. Dear students, I hope all of you got it very nicely, how to change the verb form into noun forms. Now, equally important question is there. Using the definite article with names. Dear students, generally we don't use the with proper noun, at least with the name of persons. Let's read it and try to understand. You know that the definite article the is not normally used before proper nouns, nor do proper nouns usually occur in plurals. We do not say the Nelson Mandela और नेल्सन मंडेलाज। बट नाउ लुक एट दिस सेंटेंस फ्रॉम द टेक्स्ट। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, व्हेन यू विल रीड दिस सेंटेंस यू विल कम टू नो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग व्हेन वी आर यूजिंग द विद प्रॉपर नाउन्स और वी आर यूजिंग द प्लूरल फॉर्म ऑफ प्रॉपर नाउन्स। द डेकेड्स ऑफ ओप्रेशन एंड ब्रूटेलिटी produced the Oliver Tambo's, the Walter Sisulus of our time. Dear students, here two names have been written, Oliver Tambo's, and Tambo has been made plural by adding S and the is used before this proper noun. Again, Walter Sisulus. Here with Walter the is used and it has been made plural by adding S at the end. Used in this way with the and or in plural, a proper noun carries a special meaning. For example, what do you think the names above mean? Two options are given. Number one, for example, simply the name Oliver Tambo and Walter Sisulu, or option B, many other men like Oliver Tambo and Walter Sisulu, many men of their type or kind whose names may not be as well known. Means when we add the and we use plural form of proper noun, particularly the names of people, then they become the representative of that type of people. We will learn it more. Did you choose option B? Then you have the right answer. Now there are three sentences given. We will explain these three sentences and I hope you will get the better understanding. Mr. Singh regularly invites the Amitabh Bachchans and the Shahrukh Khans to his parties. What is the meaning of this sentence? Dear students, the meaning of this sentence is Mr. Singh regularly invites great people like Amitabh Bachchan and Shah Rukh Khan. The people like them, many more people he invites, not only Amitabh Bachchan and Shah Rukh Khan, but also some other people who are like them, who are great personalities. He invites them. Sentence number two. Many people think that Madhuri Dixit is the Madhubala of our times. In this sentence, Madhuri Dixit has been compared with Madhubala. Here, Madhubala name has been used with the definite article. So, here Madhubala is not only a name. It has become a standard name in film industry for any actress. And Madhuri Dixit has been compared with the greatness of Madhubala or any other actress of that standard, that quality. Sentence number three. History is not only the story of Alexanders, the Napoleons and the Hitlers, but of ordinary people as well. Meaning of this sentence is, history is not only the story of Alexanders, means the great kings like Alexander, or the Napoleons, or the great kings like Napoleons, or the Hitlers, or the great fighters like Hitler. Here Alexanders, Napoleons and Hitlers, it doesn't mean only Alexander and Napoleon and Hitler, it means many more great kings who were equal in greatness or who were like these three. All those are represented with these three names. So dear students, I hope all of you got it nicely. You now have understood what does it mean when a proper noun, particularly the name of a person, is used with definite article or in plural form. Okay, dear students, if still there is any doubt, you can ask me. I am available in the group. Any doubt,
मोस्ट वेलकम. बी हैप्पी, बी सेफ एंड कीप लर्निंग. थैंक यू.